another video, and today I'm here gonna talk about basically my scores for, you know, what I've been talking about the last couple of days. Of course, I've been talking to y'all about my project, my preaching, my homework, and about my test. So I'm basically give y'all a summary of what happened all yesterday and stuff like that. So, you know, as yesterday, I have to do all that stuff. And I came into class and I seen on the board, on the whiteboard, that basically said each one of our names and stuff like that. And basically, we had to score each other on a piece of paper of our, you know, presentations and stuff like that. We had to score each other, and from 1 to 10, what we each got. And basically, the way that I was rating on the whiteboard, it was basically the order we have to go in. So when I see my name was like, I think it was like the fourth name. Yeah, it was the fourth name. I was excited because I was like, well, that gives me time to kind of relax and kind of get my flow through, and also to see other people and how they're doing their stuff and see their errors and kind of correct myself and kind of see how I'm gonna go about my presentation and learn from their errors. So you know, everybody gave their presentations. Of course, we gave our homework at the beginning of class, like how we always do. And basically, our homework's graded to where it's in effort instead of, like, actually if the answer is wrong or right. He doesn't grade us because of that. He just makes sure that we answer all the questions to our best of our abilities. And he gives us 100 for it and stuff like that. Of course, you leave one question blank, that's going to be wrong. So, you know, it brings down your score. Usually the questions on your homework are like about 5 to 10 questions, something in between that. So if you miss one question and didn't attempt to answer it, that could bring your score down really quickly, because, you know, percentages just work like that. You know, the more questions you have, the more chance you have of passing. The less questions you have, the more less chance you have of passing, because of the percentages of it spread out. So we turned in our stuff, you know, our little resume, our little essay, and then our homework or whatever for the questions for the chapter 8. And of course, into the presentation now. You know, everybody started going up there giving their presentation. I felt sorry for the first person that had to go. I'm pretty sure they were nervous and, you know, about the situation. So basically, in our presentation, we had 10 minutes was our minimum. So you had to reach 10 minutes at least. And that was for both presentations, the preaching and the presentation of your, you know, what you learned in the class. So both of that had to equal out to at least 10 minutes. And then the maximum had to be 15 minutes, because through this, he wants us to learn how to, for us to learn how to calculate our timing. Because as you may know, a lot of preachers sometimes don't calculate their timing. And, you know, preachings have to be from like 30 minutes to 1 hour. And there's some preachers that sometimes pass that time. They go into 2 hours, 3 hours. And, you know, what's the point of preaching that long if the people are not going to listen? You know, after a while, your mind is going to wander. So it's best to get your point out in that time period as you can. That way the people could capture what you're preaching about. And at the end of the day, that's what we want. We want people to understand what we're preaching about. We want people to reach salvation. We want people to turn their lives. We want people to come to God and stuff like that. So if you're talking too much, it kind of loses the message behind what you're trying to do. Because sometimes some preachers get to talking about other stuff that doesn't even have to do with what they're preaching about, or it goes into more like story time, or, you know, testimony time. And, you know, that part of the time already happened during the service. You know, certain churches have their testimony time, and that's when it's time for testimony. This is time for preaching. So it's good to have at least one testimony. If you want to put a testimony, just put one. Don't be putting one, you know, one testimony, then another testimony, then another testimony, then another testimony. Then the whole preaching is about testimonies. That's not how preaching works. So this right here, this 10 minute to 15 minutes kind of teaches us how to manage our time. You know, as a preacher, you have to know how to manage your time, especially if you're going to go from church to church, preaching, being an evangelist, or just being a preacher in general. You know, not everybody is going to want to have a preacher that's going to be preaching, you know, 2 hours, 3 hours. And then some churches also have a schedule set up to where they tell you, okay, you have to preach for 30 minutes, and that's the time that you have. So you have to be considerate of these churches and, you know, how they want to go about their preaching. There's some churches that be like, preach however long you want. You know, it all depends. So basically, this teaches us how to do that. So when it came time for me to go up there, of course, I preached about problems, how I talked about in the other video. If you haven't watched the other video, go ahead and watch it. You know, yes. So, yeah, so I went up there and I did my preaching first. Everybody was doing their presentation first, like their little, what they learned in class first. But Joel, our teacher, told us to go ahead and do the preaching first. That way you could get the preaching out the way and make sure that you finish the preaching and then go into the other part. But other people decided to do it the other way, but it worked for them. I think one person didn't reach the 10-minute mark or something like that. I was confused. I was kind of not paying attention when she was talking in that part. But, you know, when you're nervous, sometimes you kind of speed up everything because you're like, if I'm finished in time, you're trying to hurry yourself up and stuff like that. So I got up there and I started doing the preaching first. And somewhere around when I was about to get to my conclusion of the preaching, I looked at my timer because he told us to go ahead and have our own timer because he's not going to tell us when our 15 minutes is over. We have to control our own time. The same way when you're preaching, you're not going to have somebody over there waving their hand at you telling you, hey, your 15 minutes are up. No, they're not going to be doing that. You have to look at the time. You know, usually churches have a little watch up there or the time, and you should be able to see what time it is and when you're supposed to finish. You're supposed to be conscious of that. So you have to preach and then look at the time and then preach and look at the time and kind of get an idea of what time you want to stop. So I, right before I was getting my conclusion, I turned around and look. I started in 15 minutes. And at that point, I was at 4 minutes remaining. So I was kind of like, well, I already passed the 10-minute mark. I could start finishing my preaching and go ahead and go from there. So I, you know, went ahead and finished my preaching, did my conclusion and stuff like that. So then I went into my presentation. My presentation, I didn't, you know, do a whole bunch because I was like, well, I already went over my time limit. I'm just going to read what's on my poster and then go ahead and just give examples of what I go through and stuff like that and how this teaching, what I'm learning, is connecting with me and what I've learned and stuff like that. So I basically really talked about, you know, the interpretation of the Bible. And as y'all may know, I preach in Spanish. So there's certain parts where there's certain words that I don't understand, like, you know, in the Bible. So what I have to do, I have to go search it out, like either in a dictionary or on my phone, search it out, or also just keep reading the verse or read around the verse to figure it out. So that's how I use what we were taught, you know, and stuff like that. And then I also talked about how we need to make sure we understand what's being said in the Bible, because we don't want to fall into error and then have other people fall into error. Because what our main job is as preachers is to preach other people. So if we're causing other people to fall into this error, you know, it's going to be on us. We're teaching people the wrong stuff. So you don't want to do that. You don't want to teach that to people. So I got it over and done with. And after I was done, I was so excited. I was like, oh, I could breathe now. I could relax. So after that, once we all did our presentations, of course, we did our test. I started off my test. I was like, oh my God, like, I can't focus because of everything that just happened before. So I got my test done. I kind of made sure I read out stuff. And that's the main thing about these tests that we take. Just make sure, we just have to make sure we read out stuff, because there's certain words that he switches around. And then you have to make sure if that word was right or whatever. And, you know, because you don't want to pick the wrong one because of just the one word. Because sometimes you know how you're doing the test and you're trying to hurry up and finish and get it over with. But you didn't realize that that one word wasn't the right word. And it's just, instead of saying no, it says yes, or, you know, blah, 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 yes. And then blah, blah, blah. And then the other part, no, blah, blah, blah. So it's like little small things too that he puts in the test. So we have to pay attention to it and make sure that we're reading it out. Because the test in itself is pretty simple, but if you're not reading it, you could kind of mess up. So right here goes my my test right here. And right here was my grade that I got for my project, which was a 95. So I'm so proud of myself. A 95. So yeah, that's what's up. I worked hard on my project and I deserve it. And then right here was my test grade. It was a 98. So I'm actually glad about that. I think I only missed one question out of the whole test. Yeah, it was just one question I missed, and it was this one right here. It was supposed to be what's the different meanings of the word flesh? And then I accidentally picked the wrong one because I wasn't too sure. I was like, it could be both though. So it turned out that it really meant a person or something like that. So I was like, oh wow. Oh wow. But I still passed with a 98. So I'm proud of myself. So yep, that's it for today, guys. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Also, hit that notification bell. And y'all could get the videos every time I upload. So, y'all have a nice day. Deuces. All those feelings of depression and doubt, you gotta tell them go away.